Hello guys, I haven't been doing any videos in a while, so I just decided to took an ocean, take a video of how I paint with watercolors. Just found some spare time for this. I'm sorry of my voice. I have a bit of flu, so just bear with me there. So I basically paint on different sizes of papers, and these ones I enjoy painting on little cards, watercolor cards. So I have a wee bit of sea creatures here. I outlined them. Hopefully I'll have enough time at least to paint one in this video. I just wanna show you a bit of my equipment that I have. So these are the cards. I'll show you my watercolors. These are my favorite ones. These are the Leningrad watercolors, Russian watercolors, and I really think they're the most brilliant ones so far anyway. And I have water here and different sizes of brushes. I'll not use the big ones because these are for big paintings, and this one's really big, so put those aside for these tiny ones. Sometimes I use this, but still a bit too big. So size 10 of Dollar Roni. I find those brushes the best for me. So size 10 and size 6. I'll use these. And I need really tiny brush. This one is cheap one. I don't know where I got it. Size 0, and this is just very tiny for very small details. And this one is for masking, and this is the masking liquid I have for to save the white areas, for example. I'll open it. I can even use it from back of the lid. It's just a tiny amount that I need. This is the seahorse, and I want to save his eye. So I put a wee bit on his eye. Then I have crab. Maybe I'll just put two tiny dots just to show the shine. And then another seahorse. And I'm gonna put on this eye here. And there's two dolphins. Three tiny dots there. And the last one is the whale, but I don't need to mask anything on it. Don't know why it's not. Maybe I'll paint the seahorse first. Just put those aside. The seahorse. So first of all, I need to dip my brush in the water and I'm gonna wet the area where I'm gonna paint. Just need to soak the area where the paint gonna go. Just want to see the shine, is that enough or not? I think pretty much it. Gonna use, I think, a bit of blue. And as well, would like to grab a tiny brush and maybe make a wee strands of hair coming out in there. The wee patterns there. Mm-hmm. this for fun. Tiny bits of yellow. There. That's pretty seahorse. Now, I'll put this aside because I need this masking, because before I remove this masking liquid, I need it dry, so I'll just put this aside for the dry, and maybe paint another seahorse. This time maybe different colors. Oh, gone really, really blue color. Picked up really lot of blue color. So pretty much whatever I want, and I'm gonna use, I think, lemon, a bit of lemon color. Just way around. Do these cute strands of different growth. Now, I think I can add some more fun color, maybe a wee bit of bright green. This brush is too big for the details. Maybe just like that, and like this. Just something to stand out, maybe bright, something bright here. Yeah. And maybe I'll give a little blue. Just tweak this up here a little bit. Just tighten it up. There. If I put too much detail, it might ruin it. So I think maybe just leave it over it here, the belly area. And maybe just to define there. Now let's see if the other ones I sort of dry now. So now I can scrape the masking liquid off, and it just came off. Now I can put this aside to dry, and I'll put this eye. Make sure that this drop will not fall on the painting. So just mark it. I think really vaguely so. It's watercolor after all, so can't be too much. Maybe just so this one is basically finished. And I'll just put my signature. I like it from different colors. So I'll put two letters in purple. And one letter maybe in green. And bit of so, and other one, let's see, nearly dry. I'm afraid to ruin it. Need to. I think this little part is already dried, so here we go. And I'll put this, yes, little line here. That's it. I don't think it needs much. So I'll use for initials. I use and the last one, I'm gonna put the red one that I used in there. That's two little seahorses. I hope you enjoyed the video, and hopefully I'll find some more time and maybe paint some more little cards for you, because I think this space of time is just perfect for to paint little cards. So thank you for watching.